Blind Melon's biggest single of their career would be the song No Rain from their self-titled debut record, which came out in 1992. The song's video received a lot of airplay on MTV, and perhaps the most memorable part of the video is the B-girl. But whatever happened to her, and did the video open up future opportunities for her in show business? That's what we're going to discuss in today's video. Released as a second single from the group's debut album, No Rain would peak at number 20 on the Hot 100 charts and top the mainstream rock charts in America. The success of the single would help push their debut album to peak at number 3 on the album charts, resulting in the album selling over 4 million copies. The music video would be directed by Samuel Bayer, who had a pretty impressive resume directing Nirvana's Smells Like Teen Spirit video, and he would later go on to direct the Cranberries video for Zombie about a year later. The video would star a tap-dancing B-girl who'd be played by a 10-year-old girl named Heather Deloach, who hailed from Lake Forest, California. The concept for No Rain's video would be inspired by a 1975 photo of Blind Melon drummer Glenn Graham's younger sister, who appeared on the album's cover and served as an inspiration for Deloach's getup. Deloach, by this point, was already starring in commercials as young as 5 and claimed that she was the first person to try out for the video. According to her, the video's director thought she looked so much like Graham's sister that no other actresses were brought in to audition. She would tell MTV, "They told me Sam didn't look at any other tapes. I went in with my hair in braids and wearing those chunky glasses because they said to look nerdy. My mom said we had to find some glasses before we went in, so we ran to a local mall right before the audition and I bought them, and Sam liked them so much, they're the same ones I used in the video," she'd say. The beginning of the video sees the 10-year-old tap dancing in a bee costume to cackles of an unseen audience. Feeling bad, the bee girl runs off and meets people on the streets of Los Angeles in search of a more receptive audience before finding other people wearing a bee suit in a rolling field. Deloach said the appearance became the definition of overnight success, telling MTV, "I woke up the next morning and it was a hit. At times I wish I'd been older because it was the time of my life, like playing Halloween every day." In fact, the costume would become pretty popular for Halloween that year. Her mother Susan would tell the LA Times that shortly after the video blew up on MTV, her daughter would still flip out over seeing herself on television. A few reports after her appearance in the music video claim she was a little too confident though. Blind Melon frontman Shannon Hoon would tell Rolling Stone in 1993, "She's also been packing a Series 2, flitting around with an entourage, signing autographs, and hobnobbing with heavy hitters. I heard she was hanging out with Madonna at the MTV Awards," he'd tell the magazine. So what did Deloach think of alternative rock music? Well, she would tell Entertainment Weekly in 1995, "I hate to say this, but I'm not an alternative fan. I like Soul for Real, Salt and Pepper, TLC, oh my gosh, my favorite TLC." Following her appearance in the video, she wouldn't really hear from the members of Blind Melon, but she did land some high-profile spots, appearing at the 1993 MTV Video Music Awards, reprising her role as the B-girl to close out the show. She would also make a cameo in the Weird Al video for Bedrock Anthem, and appear in feature films including I'll Do Anything, Camp Nowhere, and A Little Princess. Deloach's schoolmates would give her a little bit of trouble over the appearance, but they're telling Entertainment Weekly, "I got teased in school for the video for a little while, but then everybody grew out of that." By 1995, she was now in the 7th grade, and told the publication that she loved acting, but at the same time she wanted to become a marine biologist. In the subsequent years, she would land roles in the Fran Drescher movie The Beautician and the Beast, as well as TV shows including Reno 911 and ER. In 2008, she would catch up with MTV, and at the time, she was still an aspiring actress, telling the network, "When people see my resume, they're like, really? You've grown to be such a beautiful woman. Sometimes I don't always want to be known as the nerdy B-girl, but it changed my life, and I'm willing to be called that forever until I'm old and gray. The B-girl is such a part of me, I could never let it go," she'd say. Then in 2017, People magazine caught up with her. Deloach at the time was 38. She was a Cal State graduate in communications, and revealed she was no longer pursuing a career in acting. By 2017, she was married to a financial advisor who she met online and was 1 year older than her, and the pair also had a younger daughter. Her wedding, however, would have a few nods to the B-girl costume. These days, Deloach represents a fertility doctor in Orange County, and almost 30 years later, she claims she still gets recognized as the B-girl, saying, "I'm not one to boast, but my friends, sister, and mother, whenever we're in a conversation with a stranger, by the end they'll bring it up and people recognize me. People come up to me all the time with stories about how I changed their childhood and got them through a tough time of not being accepted." She would make her most recent public appearance in October of 2020 on the Fox game show, I Could See Your Voice. That does it for today's video, guys. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you again on Rock and Roll Your Stories. Take care.